Hey guys, Bryan here from Liquid Concepts. So today we're gonna do a quick little video, something that we've had a lot of questions about, we've helped some customers with, and figured we'd go ahead and shoot a quick video on it. So I know I've always, in the past, we've been like, okay, let's mix this, let's do this, spray that, but sometimes we just need to go back to the basics and figure out how we need to do it, all right? And so this weekly tip and trick video is going to be on how to read a paint mixing cup. They're very simple, they're very easy to use, but whenever you're looking at numbers like all of this, you're like, oh my gosh, that's a lot of numbers. How do I know which one to do, right? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go through here and we're going to examine it, see what we need to do, and then pretty much go from there on how we need to mix it, which lines we need to go with, and everything like that. So we'll grab a part, and so let's just say that we're using our High Solids Glamour Clear. Now, again, you could see on the front here, this mixes two parts of this clear to one part of any of those three hardeners. And so essentially, this mixes 2:1. So by having a mixture of 2:1, we know that with this and the other component, then it's ready to spray. Now, the other thing is how do we know where to mix it, all right? And so the first thing that you gotta do is of course, get a paint mixing cup. So the second thing is we'll go through here and we got 2:1, 3:1, 4:1, 5, 6, and 8. And then we've got equal ratios around here. And so as we're turning this around, we wanna be at the 2:1 mark. And so, at the 2:1 mark, now we know that we are going to be in this area right in here, all right? So now that we have it figured out at 2:1, now we need to figure out, one, how much material we need, and two, which lines do we use on this to figure out how everything mixes. So reading a paint mixing cup is pretty simple. So the first thing that you wanna do is that you need to figure out, do you need this much material or do you need that much material? So depending on how much material that you need will depend on the job that you're doing. So let's just say that we've got a couple of gun stocks and say a rifle or something like that. So a complete gun and then a couple of gun stocks. So let's just say that we needed give or take about 10 ounces of material, okay? So at 10 ounces of material, we can see that if we're at around 10 ounces, that's gonna be about this high on the cup. And so what we're gonna do is we're just gonna flip this cup over, and then, so now we're actually going to be somewhere in this area right in here, all right? And so now let's take and dive into this a little bit further. So looking at this 2:1 mark, we have a 2 and a 1. So we're gonna go to this last column right here and we're gonna drop down. And so we needed to be somewhere in this area and we're in this last column here, which is on the 2:1. So we're gonna drop down and then that's going to be give or take probably either a 5 or a 6. So let's just say that it's a 6. All right, and so now that we know the number, then we can just follow the numbers from the first column to the second column. So we would pour our clear coat in this case all the way up to this 6 right here, and then we would pour our hardener to the next 6 in the next column. And so then we would just go 6 and 6, and that gives us a mixing ratio of 2:1. So very simple, very easy to do. And so all you have to know is, like I said, just a few things. Number one, your mixing ratio of what your product is going to go with. And number two, also, you need to know how much material that you're going to use whenever you are actually spraying the part. Now again, if you needed less, you can easily go to say maybe a 2 and a 2 or a 3 and a 3, and then you only get that much total amount of clear or product that you're mixing up, or this much, or even all the way up to this 8 here. So depending on how much you need, you can adjust that mixing ratio to a different number, but still getting the same ratio of 2:1. So mixing paint is not hard. Mixing any product is not hard. It's just knowing how to read the paint mixing cup and knowing where to put all of your lines at. So again, we'll kind of go over this. Let's just say that we had a 4-to-1 and we needed about the same mixture. So at 4-to-1 right here, we're gonna go to that last number that's in the mixing ratio, and that's just gonna be this middle column here. And then we're just gonna drop down. So we needed about this much material. So in this case, let's just say that it's a 7. So with the 7 right there, then we just go up to the first 7, and then the next 7. And then now we have a mixing ratio of 4-to-1. So again, not hard. And again, sometimes you will have to kind of look at it in a different light, because some mixing ratios are a little bit different. But most of the time, a paint mixing cup like this will have almost every standard paint mixing ratio from 1-to-1 all the way upwards of 6-to-1 or 8-to-1. Some of them even have 10-to-1. So depending on the ratio that you have, which should be pretty standard, 2-to-1, 4-to-1, something like that, you can go to here, find your ratio that's on the top here, and then of course just follow the lines going all the way up, and then you're ready to go. Of course, once you have it all mixed in, give it a good shake if it needs a shake, or stir it up, however it needs to be mixed up, and then pour it in your gun, you're ready to start spraying again. So something that seems pretty hard is actually pretty easy once you break it down into the steps like that, and then you're able to see exactly what you need to do. So I hope this has really helped you guys out. If you have any questions or comments, definitely leave them below. We'd love to hear from you. Also, if you haven't already, definitely hit the subscribe button. We'd love to have you subscribe to our weekly tips and tricks that we put out just about every week. And also, if you like the video, definitely give us a big thumbs up. I'm Bryan from Liquid Concepts. We're making Hydrographics great again. We'll see you guys next time.